All right, I've had a few requests that have come in specifically asking me like, hey, with your clients, Jason, what are you leveraging or what are you recommending as a LinkedIn automation tool? And specifically around automating for setting up sales sequences, either in Apollo or HubSpot, like what tool, what lead gen tool are you using? So in this video, I'm going to break down one of the tools I use, and this is going to be a two-part series. So the first video, this video, I'm going to showcase, I'm going to break it here. It's called Waalaxy. You can see it up here on the screen regardless, but Waalaxy is the LinkedIn tool, lead gen tool that I use simultaneously with Apollo and or HubSpot. So either one of those CRMs, when you're going in there, you probably know them both, but regardless, we collaborate with our clients. They're using Apollo or sometimes HubSpot. But the trigger, as you know, if you're a user in those, is the trigger is when you do the sales sequence, there's an automated trigger task to say, hey, follow this person on LinkedIn, comment on their post, invite them. And in this example, part one of this video, I want to walk you through Waalaxy and how you can automate it. So typically you would go into Apollo, HubSpot, set up your sales sequence, boom, it's going, it's running, the emails are going out there. But once you get that sequence set up, you're going to want to go into Waalaxy, and this is the dashboard here. But if you go into prospects, so that list that you've put in Apollo, put in the HubSpot for the people list, you'll want to upload that here. And just as an example, you can see this for one of our clients. They have a conference coming up and we've uploaded that list. Boom, it's here. The next thing you want to do is once it's uploaded, so you just import it, it's a CSV file, very similar to you would import any of your contacts like into HubSpot. So very similar, very easy. The next thing you want to do is you want to enroll that those people into a campaign. So boom, here's the campaign. I'm going to go over here. The reason I'm doing a two-part series on this is I've got, as you can see, a few campaigns running. And so I want to showcase because, you know, if you're uploading a list in this example of like 133 contacts, 96 contacts, 12 contacts, right? It takes time, just like you would be reaching out to your prospects to connect with them on LinkedIn. This is a great way to automate it, right? So I don't have to go through and, you know, if there's a sequence that you're setting up in HubSpot or Apollo, and there's like 100 people that you're reaching out, right? Your time is precious, right? Why would you want to go through there and manually connect with these people where you can upload it to Apollo, or I'm sorry, upload it to Waalaxy and let Waalaxy do the work for you. So part one is just to kick off Waalaxy. Part two video is going to showcase what's the results of this. So back to starting the campaign, I click on this. The cool thing and what I like about Waalaxy is there's a variety of different things that you can do. And so I just wanted to show you from a automation reach out on LinkedIn is you can send one invite, right? You can send just that invitation message, or you can send an invitation message and a sequence of two other messages. So as an example, for a lot of the clients that we're working with is we want to build trust. We want to build value. We want to build a relationship with them. So it's not just about connecting, right? What's that next message you would send to them? And so we help craft these short messages in there. But as an example for like just an invitation only, you would go in there. Let me see if I have a draft available already, but let's just do this anyways real quick. So invitation, let's go message number one. So again, this is just an invite on LinkedIn. And then you would automatically say, hey, which prospect list do you want to do? Select that, go in there. I'm not going to showcase, well, let's just do this real quick. Let's do this MedOnc list because I don't think we've used this. So, okay, do you want to add all the prospects from this list? It's a massive list. There's 2,400. So I'm just going to say yes for now. And then this is where you want to send a note. So you can put in there, hey, it's asking, do you want to do a personalized invitation? And what I want to recommend here is yes. Every person you reach out to, even if it's the same message, you definitely want a personalized invitation. Now, this video isn't about social selling, but if it was, this would be one of the recommendations, best practices for when you're reaching out to LinkedIn people, connecting with them. You want to build that personal connection with them, right? It's just not a typical, you know, connection you want to send out with no note. So in the note, in the invitation, what I typically do is, since we're very niched out in the industries that we work with, I typically say, hey, since we share similar connections in the industry, I'd love to add you to my personal LinkedIn network. you know, let's grow or with appreciation or something along those lines. And that helps build that bridge between building that relationship. So if we go back into this, yes, let's add the note and then continue. I'm not going to do it for this sequence, but I think you get this now. Again, you'll go back through there, do that. And then for this part one series two, what I like about this, I'm just going to bounce back out of this real quick because I don't want to continue with this. So let me just close this out. But essentially what you're going to want to do is, it's giving me an error here, which is fine. So let's not save change. Let's X out there, get out without saving. But what I want to be able to do is come back. And again, the strategy for this, again, launch your Apollo sequence, your HubSpot sequence. And then once it launches, go in there, upload your list here. So it automates it, right? It makes your job so much more efficient, so much more easier to connect with these people. So I'm going to do a sneak peek of my video too. Again, I launched these campaigns this week. And again, all these invites are going out. So within a week, hopefully 5 to 7 days, we'll see some better results for this. But since we just launched it like the last couple days, I've had an acceptance rate. So you can see up here, there's a variety of different, how's it going? Like what's the ranking here, right? So if it's under 15%, right, then you're going to get level zero. If it's 15 to 30%, which is the optimal way, I believe we've made it out of the atmosphere, but we're still, okay, so that's not the optimal way. Level one is just 15 to 30%. Level two is we're in orbit around our target, just need some initial landing. So 30. So the goal is really to get up to like a 50% acceptance level. And as you know, in LinkedIn development, social selling, like everybody's not going to connect with you, but that's okay. This automates it for you. So this is really a time saver, right? This is a lead gen time saving tool. So I think when I went back through there, let's look at details. So there's 74 will soon to be receiving an action, 74. And then it looks like, so I, for this campaign I've launched, it looks like I've had 5 connections for this one. Let me bounce out and let's look at another campaign, this AANP. And then, so for that one, it looks like 8. So over the last couple of days, there's 8 connections with this campaign. There's 5 with the other. So again, it's starting. It says here 0 level, but my acceptance rate is like 7.7%. But right, we want to get up to 50%. But the thing here, again, you got to let it run its course. Not everybody's going to connect right away. So just give it some time. So part two video is going to come out hopefully in 5 to 7 days next week so you can see what these results are. But as you plan out your campaigns in HubSpot and Apollo, check this tool out from a cost perspective. Waalaxy, let me see if I have this start, but I'll put this in the notes too, just so you can see what the costs are for this tool. Off the top of my head, I don't see the cost, but I can definitely put that in the notes below. And then if this video has been helpful, definitely hit the subscribe button. I want you to continue to get this information. Again, if it's been helpful, I'm going to send the part two series video up. I'm going to post that up next week. So hit the subscribe button if you want to learn more for the next video and the outcome of this. Bye for now.